Okay, good morning children. Yesterday we have seen till protocordates. All the organisms which has notochord is divided into three categories. One is urochordata, cephalochordata and vertebrata. Whereas urochordata and cephalochordata both are grouped under protocordates. So yesterday I have completed what are urochordates, what are the examples of urochordates and where do they live. As well as I have said about cephalochordate also. So we have discussed about this. And I have started vertebrates also. Once again, I will introduce what is vertebrates. So vertebrates, the organisms which has vertebral column, means in the embryonic stages, notochord is formed. Actually, we can say notochord is the first endoskeleton which is formed during embryonic stages. The first endoskeleton formed during embryonic stages is notochord. But when the organism becomes adult, notochord is replaced by vertebral column. So such kind of organisms where notochord is replaced by vertebral column, and this vertebral column will be persistent throughout the life. Throughout the life, this vertebral column will act as an endoskeleton. Such kind of organisms are included in vertebrates. So, basing on this, again vertebrate tested also I have said children, once again I will draw the flow chart. All the vertebrates are divided into two divisions. Why again I am saying is, sometimes they will ask the bit in the way of flow chart also. So all the vertebrates are divided into two divisions. So basing on what these are divided into two divisions means, whether the organism is having jaw or not, or if the organisms which are having the jaws that are grouped under one category, if the organism jaw is absent, or if the organisms are lack of jaws, that organisms are grouped in other categories. Suppose if the vertebrates are without jaws, they are called agnathas. A means absent or without. A means absent or without. Gnathos means jaws. Gnatha means jaw. So the organisms in which jaw is absent, that organisms are grouped under agnathas. Whereas the next one is the organisms which possess jaw are grouped under another category called gnathostomata. Gnatha is jaws. Gnathostomata is the mouth which has jaws. So gnathostomata are the organisms which have jaw. So all these organisms are grouped under gnathostomata. So the example for agnathas. So which organisms comes under agnathas means cyclostomata. Cyclostomata organisms comes under agnatha. Agnatha means the organisms in which jaws are lacking or absent of jaws or without jaws are called agnathas. Example for agnatha is cyclostomata. Next one is gnathostomata. Gnathostomata means the organisms in which jaws are present. So again this gnathostomata are divided into two superclasses. And children, sometimes they will give the blank here and they will ask, gnathostomata is divided into options. They will give divided into orders, classes, subclass or superclass also they will give. So gnathostomata are divided into two superclasses. What are the two superclasses? Are basing on what this gnathostomata is divided. Gnathostomata is divided into two divisions or two superclasses basing on the appendages. What are appendages? Appendages are nothing but the outgrowths of the body. So suppose if the organism bears fins, if the organism bears fins, that organisms are grouped under one category. If the organism bears limbs, if the organism bears limbs, all these organisms are grouped under one category. So which organisms bear fins are piscers. Piscers. So the organism which bears fins are piscers. So what are piscers? All the fishes are aquatic. All the fishes come under piscers. So which organism bears fins means piscers. That is fishes bears fins. So the organisms which have fins as a locomotory organ or as an appendage are grouped under superclass piscers. Now we will see the next superclass, limbs. Limbs are nothing but four limbs and hind limbs, or we can call as hands and legs. So the organism which bears limbs are grouped under tetrapods. Tetrapods. Why we are calling as tetra? Tetra means four. Tetra means tetra is four. Pods means foot. Pod is a foot. The organism which bears four feet are four limbs and hind limbs. So such kind of organisms are grouped under tetrapods. Again, this tetrapod, the way where it is living, basing on the habitat, or we can say basing on the respiratory organ. Again, these tetrapods are divided into four classes. So these tetrapods are divided into four classes, two superclasses. One is piscers, another one is tetrapods. Again, this tetrapod is divided into four classes. What are the four classes? Means amphibians. Amphibians are the organisms which lives in water and on the land. And the next one is reptiles. Reptiles, all the creeping organisms or crawling organisms comes under reptiles. Another one is caves. Caves are the organisms which fly in the air, because flightless birds are there, flying birds are there. All the birds come under caves. And the last one is mammals. Mammals means the organisms which possess mammary glands. Mammary glands are nothing but the organisms which feed their young ones with milk. So in this way, we have seen how the vertebrates are divided into different groups. Now among these, we will see about the eagnathas. The first and foremost division of vertebral column or vertebrates are eagnathas. So already I have said, what is meant by eagnatha? Eagnatha is nothing but the organisms whose jaws is absent. So the organisms which lacks jaws are called eagnathas. So in eagnatha, the example for eagnatha is cyclostomata. Cyclostomata. So now you will see about cyclostomata. Here cyclo. So cyclo means circular. Cyclo, the meaning of cyclo is circular. So cyclo is circular. Cyclo is circular. Whereas stoma. Stoma means mouth. Stoma means mouth. So these are the organisms which consists of circular mouth. So these organisms consists of circular mouth. These organisms are marine organisms. Marine organisms. What is meant by marine? The organisms which are present in seas and oceans. Or other way we can say as salt water organisms. The organisms which are living in the salt water. So that are marine organisms. So all these organisms are marine. So body and we can say these are ectoparasites. These organisms are ectoparasites. What is meant by ectoparasite? Parasites are of two types. One is ectoparasite, another one is endoparasite. Ectoparasite means the organisms which are present on the body, that is outside the body, on the body, such kind of parasites are called ectoparasites. Endoparasites means the organisms which are present inside the body. So that organisms we can call as endoparasites. Suppose Entamoeba histolytica is an endoparasite which causes amoebic dysentery. So these cyclostomata organisms are exclusive. They are marine organisms. They are ectoparasites which are present on other fishes. Which are present on other fishes. And these organisms are sectorial organisms. Sectorial. So mouth is circular and sectorial. Sectorial because they are the parasites. They suck the food materials or they feed on other organisms. So mouth is circular and sectorial. So this organism's body is long and eel-like in structure. So this organism's body is long and eel-like. So long and eel-like means here we can say that the organism, if they are long and eel-like, mostly the fishes organisms will not. So these organisms are long and eel-like. So long and eel-like means they appear because they are the marine organisms. So the organism's body is long and eel-like. Long and eel-like. Long and eel-like. So this mouth is circular and sectorial. So the body is devoid of scales. The body is devoid of scales. So cyclostomata's body is devoid of scales and fins. What is meant by devoid? Devoid is nothing but absence of scales. No scales are present on the body of cyclostomata organisms. And even fins are also absent. Fins are absent. So respiration. So respiration of these organisms, they respire with the help of gills. They respire with the help of gills. How many number of gills are present in cyclostomata organisms means 6 to 15 pairs of gills are present on either side of the pharynx. On either side of the pharynx, 6 to 15 pairs of gills. Even gill number also you have to remember, children. Sometimes they may ask the bit in the form of how many number of gills are present, because in one organism, gills are different. Cyclostomata 16 to 15. Whereas in other fishes, some have four gill lamellas are there. In some organisms, 5 to 7 gills are present. So cyclostomata organisms has 6 to 15 pairs of gills. So what is the main function of gills is for the exchange of gases. For the exchange of gases. For the exchange of gases. And one more thing what we have to see here is operculum is absent. Gills are without operculum. Gills are without operculum. So what is meant by operculum? Operculum is nothing but a covering which is present on either side of the pharynx or which covers the gills. Operculum. See here in fishes we can see in the sides it will be waving with the help of fins. On either side of the head region we can see operculum will be present. Operculum is a lid-like structure which covers the gills. So So here, the cyclostomata organisms are without operculum. Operculum is absent. Then comes to the heart. Heart is two chambers. Heart of the cyclostomata are two chambers. What are the two chambers? Is one auricle and one ventricle. One auricle and one ventricle. Heart is two chambers, consists of two chambers, one auricle and one ventricle. Circulation is closed type of circulation. Circulation is closed type of circulation. Closed type of circulation. What is meant by closed type of circulation? Closed type of circulation means blood vessels and capillaries are present. When heart pumps the blood is supplied to each and every cell through the blood vessels. Because another type of circulation also we have, that is open type of circulation. Open type of circulation is blood vessels and capillaries are absent. Because, and also in open type of circulation, blood is flowed in open spaces. So all the parts which are present in that open spaces will be bathed once the heart is pumping the blood. But here, in closed type of circulatory system, once the heart pumps the blood is passed to each and every cell, or it reaches the target cell. The circulation is closed type of circulation. Then comes to the excretion. Excretory organs are mesonephric kidneys. Mesonephric kidneys. What are mesonephric kidneys? Means, suppose when the organism is in marine water, excess amount of salt which is entering into the body must be maintained in a proper way. That process we'll call as osmoregulation. So that kidneys in these organisms, that is in cyclostomata organisms, must be able to maintain equal concentration of salts and water content in the body. So that kidneys are called a mesonephric kidneys. And the main important point is all the cyclostomata's endoskeleton. Endoskeleton means we can take cranium and vertebral column. Cranium and vertebral column is made up of cartilage. Or another word, instead of saying cranium and vertebral column, we can say as the endoskeleton of cyclostomata is made up of cartilage. And reproduction. So when it comes to the reproduction is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction means the reproduction which occurs by the fusion of male and female gamete is sexual reproduction. Fertilization is internal fertilization. Fertilization is the internal fertilization, and all these organisms are oviparous. All the organisms are oviparous. So what is meant by oviparous? Oviparous is the organism which lays eggs and gives rise to the young ones. That is called oviparous. Because another way of giving rise to young ones also is there. That is viviparous. Viviparous is the organism which gives birth directly to the young ones is called a viviparous. So all cyclostomata are oviparous. These organisms has a peculiar character. So what is the peculiar character is during fertilization, that is during spawning, these organisms spawning. What is meant by spawning? Spawning is when the fish, when these cyclostomata organisms are ready to release the eggs. That releasing the eggs we will call as spawning. Spawning is nothing but when the organism is ready to release the eggs. Actually, these organisms are marine, but during spawning time, when they are ready to release the eggs, these organisms or these fishes move from freshwater. These organisms will not spawn in marine water. So these organisms move from marine water to fresh water. Such kind of migration is called anadromous migration. Anadromous migration. So what is meant by anadromous migration? The fish, or if you give the example, we can see. So many cyclostomata fishes will be there. So for this, what is the example for this is the Petromyxon. Petromyxon is the example for anadromous migration. So Petromyxon is the example for cyclostomata. Petromyxon. The common name for Petromyxon is lamprey. The common name for Petromyxon is lamprey. So Petromyxon or lamprey, during spawning time, these organisms move from marine water to fresh water. So such kind of migration moving from marine water to fresh water is called anadromous migration. So after going to the fresh water, after entering to the fresh water, they lay the eggs. They lay the eggs. So from the eggs, what comes out? Larva comes out. From the eggs, larva comes out. After laying the eggs, these adult organisms will die. So after spawning, they, for the spawning purpose, where they are moving? They are moving from marine water to fresh water. So that movement we are calling as anadromous migration. It is important, big children. So organisms moving from marine water to fresh water, not all the organisms, cyclostomata organisms. In cyclostomata also, which organism is moving for spawning purposes? Petromyxon, or common name for Petromyxon is lamprey. So after moving to fresh water, it lays the eggs and the adult organism will die. So from the eggs, larva comes out. Again, this larva, it will not stay in the fresh water. From fresh water, again it moves to the marine water. Again it moves to the marine water. Which moves to the marine water? The larva which is present in the fresh water again moves back to its native place. That is, again moves back its habitat. What is its actually its habitat is marine water. So from fresh water, it comes to its habitat, that is marine water. So that again migrating from fresh water to marine water, the larva swimming or coming from fresh water to marine water, such kind of migration is called catadromous migration. Catadromous migration. So such kind of migration is called catadromous migration. So how many migrations we got? Two kinds of migration of the same fish. So what are the two kinds of migration? One is anadromous migration. Anadromous migration means the organism moving from marine water to fish water, fresh water, is called anadromous. The organism which is after hatching, again the larva from fresh water coming back to its same habitat, that is marine water, fresh to marine, is called catadromous migration. So another example also we can speak here. What is the other example for a cyclostomata is that is myxin. So another example for cyclostomata is, one example is a Petromyxon. Petromyxon is one example. Another example is myxin. The common name for myxin is hagfish. Common name for a myxin is hagfish. So even hagfishes are has a peculiar character. What is the peculiar character? Actually, these organisms are scavengers. These organisms are scavengers. What is scavengers means? The organisms which depend on dead and dying organisms. So these hagfishes, depends on dead and dying fishes. So we are calling as scavengers. We are calling as a scavengers. And this organism, when we disturb this organism releases a milky white fluid, from mucus glands. So when we disturb the hagfish, this hagfish releases a milky white fluid from the mucus gland. This milky white fluid, after coming out from the mucus gland, when touches with the water, it becomes slime or a thin layer around the fish. When touches with the water. So this is the these are the characters of Cyclostomata. So Cyclostomata organisms are nothing but the organisms which mouth is having circular, which has circular mouth without jaws, are called Cyclostomata organisms. All these Cyclostomata comes under Agnatha. These organisms are having a circular and sectorial mouth. Body is long and eel-like. Whereas body is devoid of scales. Scales are absent. And mouth is sectorial. It sucks the food material. It is an ectoparasite which is present on other organisms. It respects the help of gills. Number of gills present in this Cyclostomata is 16-15 pairs of gills. Gills are without operculum. Operculum is absent. Whereas the heart is having two chambers, one auricle and another one is ventricle. And circulation is closed type of circulatory system. Excretion occurs by mesonephric. Reproduction is sexual reproduction. Fertilization is external fertilization. All these organisms are oviparous. And these organisms has a peculiar character. So the examples for Cyclostomata are all this endoskeleton is made up of this cartilage. So the peculiar character of this Cyclostomata is during spawning time, the petromyxon and myxine are the examples for Cyclostomata. Petromyxon moves from marine water to fresh water for spawning purpose, for laying the egg purpose. So that word we will use as a spawning. So after laying the eggs in fresh water, the organism will die. But the movement of that organism from marine water to fresh water, we will call as a anadromous migration. Again, after the egg hatching into larva, the larva will not stay in the fresh water. Again, it comes back to its same habitat, that is marine water. After coming to the marine water, so moving from fresh water to marine water, that migration we will call as catadromous migration. So another example is myxine, or the common name for myxine is hagfish. Hagfish fishes are scavengers. They depend on dead and dying fishes. A peculiar character in hagfish, when we disturb the fish, it releases a white milky fluid from the mucus gland. When this fluid touches the water, it becomes a slime, a layer around the fishes. So this is about the Cyclostomata. Next one is Gnathostomata. Okay, children, next one is Gnathostomata. So what is meant by Gnathostomata? Gnathostomatas are the organisms which has jaw. So the organisms which has jaws are grouped under Gnathostomata. Already we have seen Gnathostomata is again divided into two groups. One is physis, another one is tetrapods. So in that we will see about a superclass called physis. So before going to this, just we will have an introduction. What is meant by physis? So all these physis are aquatic organisms. Aquatic organisms means the organisms which are present in water. So what kind of water? Marine water and fresh water. So physis are present in marine water and fresh water. So the respiratory organs of these are gills. Gills are the main respiratory organs. Gills are the main respiratory organs of Organs of Pisces. These organisms are developed during, or these organisms are developed during Devonian period. Devonian period. So this Devonian period is called the Golden Age of Pisces. Golden Age of Pisces. So which is known as the Golden Age of Pisces? Devonian period is known as Golden Age of Pisces. Golden Age means in which, during which period these organisms are developed well. So more number of Pisces has evolved in which period is Devonian period. So this Devonian period we are calling as Golden Age of Pisces. And the vertebral column will be persisting throughout the life. Vertebral column in these organisms will be persistent throughout the life. Throughout the life, this vertebral column is persistent. Vertebral column is persistent throughout the life. And these organisms bear fins. Fins which are used for locomotion. Studying about Pisces is called ichthyology. Ichthyology means studying about fishes or Pisces. Studying about fishes is known as ichthyology. Studying about what is meant by ichthyology? Studying about fishes is known as ichthyology. Already we have seen in the flowchart, children, Pisces. All the Pisces are divided into two categories. So basing on what these are divided into two categories means, Pisces are divided into two classes. What are the two classes? The super order Pisces is divided means, it is divided into two classes. What are the two classes? Are chondrichthyes. Chondrichthyes, another one is osteichthyes. Chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. So what is meant by chondrichthyes and what is meant by osteichthyes? Chondrichthyes means the endoskeleton which is made up of with cartilage. So all that organisms whose endoskeleton is made up of with cartilage, they are grouped under chondrichthyes. The organisms whose endoskeleton is made up of with bone, which organism's endoskeleton is made up of with bone, that organisms are included under osteichthyes. So now in detail, we will see about chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. The first one is chondrichthyes. Chondro, the first subclass or class, chondrichthyes. So chondro means cartilage. Chondro means cartilage. Ichthys is nothing but fishes. Ichthys means a fish. The fishes whose endoskeleton is made up of with cartilage. The fishes whose endoskeleton is made up of with cartilage, such kind of organism comes under chondrichthyes. Once again, children, the organisms of the fishes whose endoskeleton, what is endoskeleton? Nothing but which gives the protection to the organism. Endoskeleton, we can say vertebral column is made up of its cartilage. Cranium is made up of its cartilage. So the endoskeleton is made up of with cartilage. Such kind of organisms comes under chondrichthyes. So all these organisms are marine organisms. Marine, or we can say exclusively marine. What is meant by exclusively marine means the these organisms, chondrichthyes organisms, cannot survive in fresh water. They are present only in marine water. They are present only in marine water. Such kind of organisms we are calling as exclusively marine. So all chondrichthyes organisms are exclusively marine organisms whose body is made up of with cartilage. Body means endoskeleton is made up of with a cartilage. So body is long and streamlined. Long and streamlined. So the body of these organisms is long and streamlined. Body is covered with a placoid scales. Body is covered with placoid scales. And also you have to remember, children, we are speaking about gnathostomata. These organisms are having jaws. So body is covered with placoid scales. So what is meant by placoid scales? So here, placoid scales are the scales which are present, the scales which are the body which is covered with the placoid scales. The body which is covered with the placoid scales comes under the body. Here the body is covered with the placoid scales. So now I will say what is meant by placoid scales. So before going here, placoid scales are, the placoid scales are stiff, they are not flexible. So placoid scales are minute, and these are stiff. Suppose the placoid scales appears to be like this. The placoid scales which covers the body of chondrichthyes appears to be like this. See, why I am drawing here is another kind of fishes are there. So those fishes will be having cycloid scales. Cycloid is circular. But here the fin is not, if the structure is like this, you will call as cycloid scales. But there is lot of difference between placoid scale and circular scale. Circular scale or we can say thinoid scale, circular scale. So the body of chondrichthyes are covered by placoid scale. Whereas the teeth of these fishes, teeth of streamlined means in the middle a line can be seen. So what is the use of this streamline means? This streamline is very active, or it acts as a sensory organ which can detect these organisms, or which can act as a defense mechanism. When any other predator comes near it, this streamline will be very active. Because of this streamline, it can easily swim in the water, as well as it acts as a defense mechanism. The body is covered with the placoid scales. Placoid scales are stiff. They are stiff scales. They are not flexible. These placoid scales are minute, or we can say small, which are rigid in structure. Stiff as well as we can call as a rigid in structure. So the teeth of these chondrichthyes are also made up of with the placoid scales. Teeth are very sharp. These organisms' teeth are very sharp, and they are made up of with the placoid scales. Such kind of teeth are called placoid dermal. They are called placoid dermal teeth, or we can call as the dermal denticles also. Dermal denticles. The teeth of these organisms are made up of with the placoid scales. Why the teeth are made up of with the placoid scales are, these placoid scales are stiff and rigid. So the teeth of these organisms are made with placoid scales. Such kind of teeth we are calling as dermal denticles. These dermal denticles are directed backwards, which are very sharp, used for predaceous. These organisms are predaceous organisms. Predaceous organisms means which depend on other organisms. which depend on other organisms we'll call as predaceous. So these organisms are predaceous. Teeth are very sharp. Teeth are made up of with black white scales. Such kind of teeth are called dermal denticles. So respiration. Respiration of these gills are present is 5 to 7 gills are present, not paid summer, only gills are present. So what kind of gills? Lamellary form, lamellae gills are present. So respiration occurs by gills. 5 to 7 lamella gills are present. Whereas gills are without operculum. Gills are without operculum. Operculum is absent. Operculum is nothing but a structure which covers the gills. But here in cartilage fissures, in cartilaginous fissures or in cartilage fissures, these gills are without operculum. Gills are without a operculum. So one peculiar character is present in this. While saying reproduction, I will say here in these organisms, hydrostatic organ, or we can call as air bladder. Air bladder is absent. Air bladder is absent. What is meant by air bladder? All the cartilaginous fissures, air bladder is absent. Cartilaginous fissures, what is absent? Air bladder is absent. Name itself, air bladder. What is the function of air bladder? Air bladder acts as buoyancy. Air bladder acts as buoyancy. What is meant by buoyancy? Buoyancy, or we can call as hydrostatic organ. Buoyancy or hydrostatic. So air bladder acts as buoyancy, buoyancy or hydrostatic. Hydrostatic organ means, suppose if the organism is not swimming, the organism will sink to the bottom. But air bladder is present inside the body, the organism or the fishes will not sink. But whereas in cartilaginous fishes, air bladder is absent. Because of air bladder absent, this organism has to swim continuously. They have to swim continuously to prevent from sinking. Sinking and munigi podu. So to prevent from sinking, this organism has to swim continuously. So they have to swim continuously. They have to swim continuously. If suppose if air bladder is present, air bladder acts as hydrostatic organ. So you may have a doubt, in which organism air bladder is present? The organism whose endoskeleton is made up of its bone. So bone fissures, bony fissures, organisms, air bladder is present. So which, in which organisms air bladder is absent? In cartilaginous fissures, air bladder is absent. So air bladder is absent. And another peculiar here, so we will see the circulation. So circulation, circulation is closed type of circulation, whereas heart is having two chambers. One is auricle, another one is a ventricle. One auricle and one ventricle. Circulation is closed type of circulation. One is auricle, another one is a ventricle. So then we'll see about the reproduction. So reproduction, reproduction is sexual reproduction. Reproduction is sexual reproduction. Reproduction is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is by the formation of male and female gamete. So by the fusion of male and female gamete, the reproduction which occurs by the fusion of male and female gamete is called sexual reproduction. Fertilization. Fertilization is, fertilization in cartilaginous fissures is internal fertilization. Mostly in fissures we can see external fertilization with the legs, eggs will be laid outside in the water, but fertilization occurs inside the water. But whereas in cartilaginous fissures, fertilization is internal. It occurs inside the body. Development is Development is direct development. Development is direct development. But here, what is here? I said one peculiar character is there in reproduction. So what is that peculiar? This chondric or the cartilaginous fishes has a clasper near the pelvic girdle. Clasper. A clasper is present near the pelvic girdle. So what is meant by pelvic girdle? If you see here, children, this fin is called caudal fin. So because before learning what is pelvic fin, we have to learn how many fins are present on the body of the fish. So the last, that is posterior part of this, posterior part of the part which is present for the fish is caudal fin. So caudal fin, or we can call as tail fin also. Caudal fin or tail fin. So on either side of the caudal fin, the fins which are present are called anal fins. So this fin is called dorsal fin. So below to the dorsal fin, we can have, that is pelvic fin. Near to the operculum, a small fin will be present. That small fin which is present near the operculum is called pectoral fin. So how many fins are there, children? Dorsal fin, anal fins, caudal fins, pelvic fin and pelvic fin. So near to the pelvic fin of male fishes, a clasper is present. What is meant by clasper? Clasper is nothing but a small hole which gives out semen. In which organisms claspers are present? Mostly in male fishes. Male cartilaginous fishes has a clasper near the pelvic fin. Near which fin clasper is present? Pectoral, pelvic, anal or caudal fin? Pelvic fin. So near to the pelvic fin, clasper is present, where semen is released and which helps for the fertilization. And here also one thing you have to remember, mouth of cartilaginous fishes are ventral. So the examples, and some of these cartilaginous fishes will develop some electrical organs. Electric organs in its body which helps for the defense mechanism. Some cartilaginous fishes develops electric organs which helps for the defense mechanism. So which fishes, which cartilaginous fish is having electric organ is torpedo. Torpedo is the example which has electrical organ. Electric organs means we can call as electric fish also. It will be emitting light, or it will be emitting electric, that is a little shock. Electrical shock will be emitting from this torpedo fish. And some organisms will be having poisonous organs also. Some chondrichthyes, that is some cartilaginous fishes have poisonous stings are present. So the example which fishes has poisonous sting means that is trigon fish. So the fish, trigon fish, has poisonous sting. So now we will see the examples. So the examples of cartilaginous fishes. Is Scoliodon. Common name is called dogfish. Common name is called dogfish. Pristis. Common name for pristis is sawfish. Another one is Carcharodon. Another example for cartilaginous fish is charcodon. star carodon. This is great white shark. This will call as a great white shark. Even common names also you have to learn. Great white shark and electric fish. So electric fish example is torpedo. Torpedo common name is electric ray fish. Electric ray fish. Electric ray fish. And another one is trigon. Trigon. So trigon we will call as a sting fish. Trigon. Sting fish. So these are the examples for chondrichthyes. That is cartilaginous fishes. Scoliodon, dogfish, pristis, sawfish, very powerful. And carchorodon, great white shark, torpedo, electric ray fishes, trigon, that is a trigon, that is sting fish. And here one thing you have to remember, children, when we see the difference between cartilaginous fishes and bony fishes, all these organisms are viviparous, not oviparous. It is viviparous. What is meant by viviparous? Directly it gives young ones. The organisms which gives directly the young ones are the organisms which reproduces directly the young ones. Such kind of organisms are called viviparous. So all cartilaginous fishes are viviparous. So the next one is the next subclass or the next class of gnathostomata is, after cartilage already in the introduction I have said, what is it? The fishes whose endoskeleton is made up of with bone. The fishes whose endoskeleton is made up of with bone. So what is the term used? So the second class is osteichthyes. Osteichthyes is the next class. So all the pieces are grouped under two categories. One is chondrichthyes, another one is osteichthyes. So here osteon. Osteon means bone. Osteon is bone. Osteon is a bone. Ichthys means fishes. Ichthys. Ichthys means a fishes. So the organisms whose body is made up of with bone. The organisms whose endoskeleton is made up of with bone, such kind of fishes comes under class of osteichthyes. Osteon means bone, ichthys means fishes. So the fishes whose endoskeleton is made up of with bone, such kind of organisms comes under osteichthyes. All these organisms are aquatic. Aquatic. Why here we are not using marine means aquatic means these bony fishes are present in marine water and fresh water. These organisms are present in marine water and fresh water. Body is long. Body of these organisms is long, elongated, long. Elongated and consists of streamlined. So streamlined body. The body of these fishes are long, elongated and streamlined. Long, elongated and streamlined. Body is covered with a thinoid or circular scales. Circular scales. Already in cartilaginous fishes I have drawn. What is the difference between placoid scales? Placoid means which will not be circular. But whereas sternoid are these are circular scales or thinoid scales, which are soft and flexible. These are small and rigid. These are rigid, hard and rigid. But whereas these circular scales are soft and flexible. So the body of these bony fishes is covered by circular scales which are flexible. So these organisms has respires with the help of gills. So respiration occurs by gills. Respiration occurs by gills. How many gills are present? Means 4 gill lamella are present. 4 gill lamella are present on either side of the body. Respiration occurs by gills. How many? What is the count of gills in cartilaginous fishes? 5 to 7 gills. But whereas the gill number in bony fishes is 4 gill lamella are present. And gills are covered with operculum. Operculum is present. Gills are covered with operculum. Gills are covered with the operculum. The main organ called air bladder is present. Air bladder is nothing but a hydrostatic organ. What is meant by hydrostatic organ? This hydrostatic organ prevents the bony fishes from sinking. So if these organisms are not swimming for a while also, this air bladder acts as hydrostatic organ and prevents the fishes without sinking. Without sinking means it won't fall if the fish is not swimming for a little time because of hydrostatic organ called air bladder. So that process we can call as buoyancy. Buoyancy is nothing but which prevents the organism without sinking in the water, though the fish is not swimming also. This organism heart is of two chambers, that is one auricle, same like cartilaginous fishes, one auricle and one ventricle. Circulation is closed type of circulation. These organisms gives out excretion. So excretion is through kidneys. The excretory substance which comes out from these organisms is ammonia. What is meant by ammonia? So cartilaginous fishes excrete urea. So that organism is called ureotelic. Cartilaginous fishes, suppose if you have a doubt, cartilaginous fishes gives out urea. It is called ureotelic organism. Bony fishes gives out ammonia. They are called amnotelic organisms. So cartilaginous fishes gives out urea, whereas bony fishes gives out ammonia. So they are called ureotelic fishes, whereas these are called amnotelic. But here, what are urea and what is ammonia is, after metabolic activities, the waste materials must be sent out. So these waste materials are nitrogenous waste material. One is urea, ammonia, another one is uric acid. But cartilaginous fishes gives out urea as a nitrogenous waste material. Bony fishes gives out ammonia as a nitrogenous waste material. But here one more thing you have to remember, children. Whereas the cartilaginous fishes which gives out urea, that urea will not be excreted out from the body. Very important bit, man. Cartilaginous fishes which gives out urea, this urea will not be excreted out. But the urea which comes out as a nitrogenous waste material will be stored in the blood itself. In the form of urea. That is called physiological uremia. Physiological uremia. Physiological uremia. What is meant by physiological uremia? That is the cartilaginous fissures which stores urea in the blood for maintaining osmotic balance. For maintaining osmotic balance, or we can call it for maintaining osmotic concentration, it won't release you. The osmotic or osmotic balance. So such kind of process is called physiological uremia. But whereas, then come to the bony fissures. So bony fissures excrete ammonia. So these organisms are called amnotelic organisms. Amnotelic, ammonia is the nitrogenous waste material which comes out as an excretory excretion. Then reproduction. So reproduction is sexual reproduction. Reproduction which occurs by the fusion of male and female gamete is called sexual reproduction. Fertilization is external fertilization. In the cartilaginous fissures we have seen internal fertilization which occurred inside the body. Fertilization is external fertilization. Development is direct development. But all these organisms are oviparous. Already I have said difference, children. Oviparous and viviparous. Oviparous means the organism which lays eggs and gives rise to the young ones are oviparous. The organisms which gives directly birth to the young ones are viviparous. Even human beings, man, we are viviparous. But whereas sharks, that is cartilaginous fishes, are viviparous, bony fishes are oviparous. So this is about the osteichthyes. But we will see the example. Even here, in the starting itself, I have said these are aquatic, that is marine as well as fresh. So we will see the examples. Which are the bony fishes present in the seawater and which are the bony fishes present in the freshwater? Suppose if you see the bony fishes present in marine water. Bony fishes in marine water is the marine water. Exocetus. Exocetus is the marine bony fish. We can call this exocetus. Another one is hippocampus. Common name for exocetus is flying fish. Common name for exocetus is flying fish. Another marine fish is hippocampus. Hippocampus